Greetings. I really was hoping that the rapture would happen during Rosh Hashanah this year. Well, I hope you are not disappointed. I have to admit that I was. But you know what? It does not impact my faith, and I hope it does not impact yours. The rapture did not happen, and I do not know with certainty when it will happen. But while I may not know, God does. And I want you Christians to listen very closely to me. Okay, more precisely, I want you to listen to Peter. For we have not followed cunningly devised fables when we made known unto you the power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, but were eyewitnesses of his majesty. Peter was an eyewitness to the miracles that Jesus worked. For he received from God the Father honor and glory, when there came such a voice to him from the excellent glory, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." And this voice, which came from heaven, we heard, when we were with him in the holy mount. Peter was there to hear God declare Jesus was his beloved Son. And when did Peter and others hear the voice of God from heaven? It's written in Mark 9:7, "Then a cloud formed overshadowing them, and a voice came out of the cloud, 'This is my beloved Son, listen to him.'" It's written in Luke 9:35, "Then a voice came out of the cloud saying, 'This is my Son, my chosen one, listen to him.'" It's written in Matthew 3:17, "And behold, a voice from heaven said, 'This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased.'" And it's written in Matthew 17:5, "While he was still speaking, a bright cloud overshadowed them," or covered them, "and a voice from the cloud said, 'This is my Son, whom I love. With him I am well pleased. Listen to him.'" Then Peter continues and says this, "We have also a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto you do well that you take heed, as unto a light that shines in a dark place, until the day dawn and the day star arise in your hearts." Come again? "We have also a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto you do well that you take heed." Think about that. "We have also a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto you do well that you take heed." Peter has just said, "We were eyewitnesses to the majesty of Jesus. We were even there to hear God speak from heaven." And then he says this, "We have a more sure word of prophecy, more certain, more sure, more than that, better than being an eyewitness. We also have a more sure word of prophecy, better than hearing a voice from the clouds. We also have a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto you do well that you take heed, as unto a light that shines in a dark place." Better than being an eyewitness, because your eyes can be tricked or deceived. "We also have a more sure word of prophecy, better than hearing a voice from the clouds, because some will claim you are only hearing things. We have also a more sure word of prophecy." But what gives prophecy such significance? Prophecy proves the message is from God. More precisely, it proves it comes from a God, a being who exists outside of time itself. Christians, if you find yourself in a denomination which does not teach about prophecy, you are missing a significant part of the message of God through the prophets. I recently watched a long video by Chuck Missler, and perhaps you have already seen it. On YouTube, it is titled, Chuck Missler, People Are Awesome 2014. It is a very long composite video, over 4.5 hours. And in the first hour, he speaks of time, of space-time, of prophecy, and of mathematical probability. And while those seem like dry topics, his video is about the best treatment of the material I've ever watched. Please, do yourself a favor and watch at least the first hour. And watch it again and again until you understand the concepts. Until you really understand the concepts. On YouTube, it is titled Chuck Missler, People Are Awesome 2014. The prophecy fulfilled by Jesus is irrefutable proof. Irrefutable proof that God exists and Jesus is who the prophets said he was. Irrefutable proof once you understand the math and the concepts. The prophets reveal detail after detail after detail about Jesus. Before Jesus comes, we have also a more sure word of prophecy. Whereunto you do well that you take heed, as unto a light that shines in a dark place. The future is a dark and unknowable place, at least to us creatures who exist in the dimension of time. So watch Chuck's video. It is worth the time. Then begin to study all the references he gives. Study to show yourself approved unto God, a workman that does not need to be ashamed. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.